we have Eclarides, and mainly with mauls and short swords, very, very heavily armored team. On other end, we have Crippled Squad, also quite heavily, but quite heavy team, but not as much.
They are also using a lot of Sicalia Militia, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 as well. And on Royal Legion's side, or Crippled Squad side, we see almost no ranged at all.
I think right now, fully to the tower, seems like the final push will be here. Will the Crippled Squad rotate in time? They are doing it, but not that fast, I guess. Many units still left on the gate, not moved. We will see where the Eclarides will go. Yeah, this is quite often played rotation on this map, and what they need to watch out is trebuchets. Once more, the trebuchets flying in the middle of the units. Not too lucky for the attacking. Yeah, not kidding.
This is so interesting. Looks like if this might actually be a flank on two sides, if it's efficient from Crippled Squad. The team that was on the left side is catching some of Eclarides, as the guys that were on the A point are actually starting to push on Eclarides as well. But let's go to as the traps fly in.
Yeah, and Eclarides, they were ready for that. They were ready for that with the trebuchets, with the call. They had the people prepared to just call it. Guys, look back and kill them. And they did that, but they are trembling. They are dying, right? All the units are dead, few heroes left. But the flank here is moving. There is just one longbow. Oh my god, the light armor defending the plus throughout all these units. This is going to be quite hardcore. We can see already the rest jumping in with Maul, picking some people down, and the whole team is rotating. They will be here in a moment. The B will not go definitely for sure, but the plus is Eclarides, and this can be big. They can just take units here, and look how far away the plus is for the defenders right now. They cannot necessarily do anything if they lose any units. Fortunately enough, this spot is quite covered from the trebuchets, so the attacking side cannot use the trebuchets that much. We can see advances over advances from Eclarides. Very nice cooperation with the pikes. And yeah, seems like defenders don't have too many units left right now. They will be trying to still fight for this B point. Advance moving in. Another set of Imperial pikes is coming from the flank, so they will be fighting for this. Is it a good decision, though?
Some Kef is going to come in as well for Eclarides, so this might be very crucial in starting to come back on this one. But they're still fighting really well on Crippled Squad side. As we see the Armingers coming in from the back, look at that. Ooh, I think it got caught by some Star Wars and Impikes.
Yes, not that effective, but this charge from the back, oh, nice idea, but very well caught by Eclarides. Counter advanced from the Pikes, but in that time, the advance is coming to the A. So all the people that died over here respawned and captured A and another plus. So right now, Eclarides are in a quite good spot where they have both pluses. Yes, most of their team have died, but they have captured 8.
Yeah, looks like it. And Lewanoga is trying to be annoying with the javelins from the top. But look at this. This is going to be a fight.
Yeah, a lot of units. Mainly the shields are over here. Not too many pike units. Two Fortebrachos we can see. One Zicalian Militia. Only one advice, I believe. Advance. So this can be devastating to the Crippled Squad because they have... Yeah, they have lost this initial defense line. Right now we have Imperial Arquebusers shooting very nicely from safe distance, cavalry charging from left, from right, very interesting thing. And remember, the spawn point is there, so if they will be able to spawn with someone and attack from the back, this can be devastating for Eclarides. But right now, Eclarides seems to have upper hand. Yes, they are countering, Crippled Squad is countering quite nicely all the cavalry. Seems like the cavalry is gone, but still, shields, very defensive unit, very high HP values. They are able to still stay alive, and pikes still alive as well, advancing forward. And yeah, this is not looking too good in my opinion for Crippled Squad, yeah, especially that second.
Quite a lot of heroes on the field, but Kef is coming in from the left side as well. Look at this, Machin going in and Moriar as well. They are trying to flank, and they're also using the traps right now as well.
Yeah, shutting them down. So this is the devastating, unfortunately, trap. Not too good because it's hitting mostly their own units. But still, what we can see from Crippled Squad right now on the cap is few heroes and just one stalwart unit. Not too much, except this Landknecht, who are for some reason not participating in the fight. No idea what's going on over there. But generally speaking, the game doesn't look too good. Only 5 heroes alive from Crippled Squad right now. Yes, they have this flank going on. They can do something here unexpected from Eclarides. But to retake this point throughout all these trebuchets and fights, this is gonna be hell of a fight. So we'll be able, if they can do anything here.
Totally. Crippled Squad really needs to think again about the game plan. They need to create more flanks. They could have flanked from the left, and now as well they could have come in with Kev from the flank, but it's too late.
Yeah, and the game is done. Amazed on how they... This is a difference, but overall, yeah, not that many differences. And when it comes to units?
Yeah, it's similar, I think. But they finally start to group on top of the siege tower.
Yes, and we can see much faster rotation from Eclarides, I guess.
As they continue to rotate, and let's see how quick Cripples or Eclarides is to doing this. They've already got some guys on the supply, and they seem to be rotating quite fast, actually.
Yeah, and we can see already a big difference. Eclarides not deciding to defend on the upstairs. And
yeah, but look at the A point. It's actually getting pushed during, in a gate as well as on the top.
Yeah, so it wasn't fake push because they are not coming back. They are still putting pressure on B, but it seems that they are dividing the map in half. And half of the force is fighting here on A, while other half is getting their attention on B point.
Cripple Squad is starting to create quite a lot of chaos here. They've split up in three parts. So one part is actually going back to the A point right now, as Lewonoga is still continuing to annoy them. Oh, look at this. Another nice kill from Pirate Mango with the javelins.
Yeah, very nice throw. And yeah, seems like they are having the upper hand right now. Berserkers chopping down everyone who is standing on A point. Not nice. That many units lost. Yes, the gate push was not successful. Two people were attacking versus three or four defenders, so they didn't have the numbers there. But this was not the main attack. The main attack was here on the top, and this is successful. They managed to capture the A point. They managed to secure the defensive position, chipping in again with the Berserkers on the front line. Javelins flying from the back. Hortebrachas covering this entrance. Back is covered by more javelins, more pikes. Everything under control, and the A point goes to Crippled Squad. Javelins here from the top. Levanoga placing his javelins very tactically, but counter attack is coming in. Is this something that they expected? We will see in a moment. Crippled Squad running away from the initial push and coming in once more with the advances. They have quite a lot of Namcans shooting. They have just few pike units all around, but they don't have too many manpower. They don't have the heavy hitting or heavy surviving units, and this seems to be going into favor of Eclarides. They are pushing away the attackers. Horses, very nice charge. Yeah, in the back. This was very well executed charge, and we'll see if this will allow the pushing side from Crippled Squad to regain their ground. Namcans, yeah, the damage both from the Namcans on the top, this is, yeah, they are winning the fight. Trebuch, seems like the push is continuing. We can see the back team is going to pressure the plus point, not allowing the defenders to pick new units, and the main attack here have to deal with these horses. More horses coming in, this is from the attacker side. Not too many units left, so this is going to be a little bit of damage from Eclarides. Just few pikes here left, all the units are pretty much gone. We can see only a few stalwarts over here and only a few Hortebrachas left. If Crippled Squad will be able to close them nicely with trebuchets, come on, trebuch, cooldown is off. Okay, flying in, will they be able to finish it off right here in the similar, quite fast-paced game? We'll see in a moment.
Yeah, and let's look at the left side. Belanda is going to go around with the Armigus again, as Armigus are also coming from the top, I think, and this might be a two. Sided attack to clear up Eclarides, as we can already see Crippled Squad trying to get new units.
Yeah, a little bit overextending in my opinion. Shouldn't they as they have 9 minutes left? This is still 9 minutes in the game.
So much time, and look at the deaths, right? They have five players that are out already, and Eclarides is almost at full strength, so they have all the time to roll there. They should just take it easy, for sure.
Know what he's doing, definitely. We can see some of the Namcans were placed here on the top, very nice, but they were not enough. And right now, Crippled Squad taking the push here to the last point, attacking the main corner here on the right side with the pikes, with the advances and so on. Very well. Trebuch closing in and units coming from behind. And they are a little bit in a problem, I guess. Eclarides, yeah, they waited them out. They waited the advances out, but another advance is coming in. Will it be enough? Doesn't look like it.
It sure isn't. There's still four trebuchets left, so they can keep throwing it in. Belanda's trying to get in there with his armigers on the top side.
Mm-hmm. Coming in from behind. The advance was quite short, quite poor, but was enough, I guess. Some of the players from Crippled Squad managed to capture the point on the back and create a diversion and distraction from behind, but it was not enough.
Yeah, and crucially, we can see that there's only 9 players on Crippled Squad side that actually have units. There's not so much left there, whereas Eklaritis has got 13 players left with units.
From squad perspective, this is doable, but swift attack with woodcutters might be hard. Let's see where they will go. Very nice charge from Shortsword, placing down all the units one by one. Oh my god, very nicely staggered ultimates. Landknecht in back. They are being blocked right now, and the cavalry is coming. The cavalry is coming. Oh my god, clearing everyone from the front. Definitely not everyone from Crippled Squad move.
Crippled Squad, perhaps it can do something good here for them.
Yeah, not everyone from the Crippled Squad attacked at the one place, so they had few people in behind coming in for the second attack, but the cavalry from Eklaritis have cleared and one up, and this is over. They are not going to be spawned.
Like, and look at that, we can see what we mentioned before, so many death on Crippled Squad side, and they are dead for good. There's only 5 guys left, I think, with even half lives.
And with that, 5 last seconds, we'll be finishing the victory of Eklaritis, 2-0, red side wins. Congratulations to the victorious teams, and I guess congratulations to both teams.